So we have both cases here. This is the sawtooth, the early one. I want to remove this one and that one. And if I can move these, swap these, hopefully I can make the harder cage fit. Because this one is deeper here. So hopefully that clears the CPU. This doesn't. I could obviously just cut away a piece there, cut away, you know, harder holder and all that, the optical unit. As if I really don't want to do that, I can avoid it. These pieces off that were sticking in here. I had to do it bent, facing inwards. I had to do that in the garage, so that's why it's not on camera. I figure if I can make this fit, I can use this to align the shelf inside later. So now we have the piece in place here, and it seems to work. So other than change now this whole middle section, I think we have done everything we should. So once we make this intake, it's set to exhaust now. Doesn't matter right now. So we can take in air back here, exhaust it through the power supply. Hopefully get the hot air from the CPU and everything else out. So while the case is internally mostly done, I have ordered a power supply, and while we wait for other things to arrive so we can continue, I want to tackle the outside of the system. I don't know how well it shows here, but I have a lot of scratches on most panels. A scratch here, along here is a scratch. I've got some scuff marks. And we have some marks here. So I would like to fix that. To fix this problem, I have Altosol. I've tried it on the donor mic and it seems to work, removing scratches. I also have some scratches here on the Apple logo. I think that should show it. You can see. So we will try to remove that. So I washed it off and used some car polish just to see if I can do something. Very small scratches on it. I compared it to the other one and it's even worse, so I must have done something right at least. But the car polish at least gave it a really nice gloss, and it was really like rugged before, like sandpaper, really oxidized. So now it's very smooth and it actually has a nice shine to it. So it's not like new, but it's definitely an improvement compared to before. So I will do the same to the other side and bits and pieces. Just that design, it has some real scratches here in the middle, some serious ones, and something in the back. Don't know if it's like the color doing something, the paint behind, because they are painted on the back side. So I don't think it can do much about that, but the scratches at least, to get them away. Polished it up. Still some small dents from something hitting it once, but most of the scratches are gone and it's shiny again. So it's not gonna look like new, but it's gonna look way better.
I have put the case back together again. I chose to use the later handles and feet from the 2002 model. I think they look better, and the other ones were a bit yellowed for some reason. And I chose to use the stainless screws from the later one. So the case has been, like I showed, polished to get some kind of finish on it back again. It's not like brand new, but it's a lot better, so I'm pretty happy. Some things left to do, because we changed out the hard drive and optical cage to find 25. This doesn't work right now. We do need to add a spacer here for the optical drive, if we want that to work, but that's a minor thing. I did modify the speaker. The old one was broken, more or less. It was scratching, so the paper was had really crumbled, so I took the speaker out of the other one, modified this holder to accept this one. So this should sound a lot better. Case is more or less done, so we can start mounting things in it. The motherboard and the CPU and so on, test it out. Now what we want to try when the CPU cooler is mounted is to see if here we can actually close this. Because the whole idea is that this should... And it didn't. So, this top end here interferes, so we need to do something about that. So, I have made a small incline here. It took off about 6 to 7 millimeters here. With an angle grinder, so I had to borrow that. And then I filed it and sanded it and wet sanded the last one, last bit. So now I hope it should fit. It should be way clear up here at least, so hopefully it doesn't hit here. But we're gonna find out. So let's try and close it. Pretty sure.
Yeah, it's about 5. At the beginning it's about 2-3 millimeters at the screws at the bottom of the optical drive, but that soon clears very easily, and then it's about 5 or 6 millimeters at least.
So once it's closed, it's a good quarter of an inch clearance everywhere, you know. So now it closes. So for actual CPU cooling, I have 2 new fans. And 2 fan grills, and then some cables. I'm gonna attach the case fan and the CPU fans to this. That way I can disconnect the case fan if I want to remove the CPU cooler. These fans are, I think, 2,500 RPM, 0.36 watts, obviously 12 volts. So they're 260 millimeters by 25. I think they're maglev, if I recall I picked that, instead of ball bearing or a sleeve. So that it even says maglev on here, I don't know if you can see. But yeah, it's soon on maglev fans. I'm going to start by hooking these up so we actually have some power. So, I figure the fans should go like this. One slight problem though, I had screws there. That seems to work quite well. But these ones, I won't attach to anything because of the clip goes here. But the other ones work, so my plan is to actually glue the fans in the middle here. Just one side rather. So, now we have the fan assembly here. I said I glue them together since this is their purpose in life and nothing else, so figure like so.
closes. Yeah, now we get good clearance and doesn't interfere. So that's nice. I think this came out really nice. So, here I have the SATA card we're gonna flash. Silicon image SIL 3112, and these have Mac support, but we need a Mac firmware on here. So I have downloaded the firmware and the flash tool for DOS, so we're gonna have to use a PC with a DOS on it. So to flash this card we need to use a PC with DOS on it. So I'm gonna use this Socket 7, Super Socket 7 system with Windows 98, so we can go into DOS at boot. So I booted into safe mode command prompt only, so we don't load anything we don't need. It might interfere with the flashing. So put everything on the C drive at the bottom here. We need UDP flash, and then we got firmware.bin. So. This should be it. If I can type UDP flash firmware.bin, and we need to select number 2 because that's the SIL 3112 we have. 680, I'm not familiar with, but it's not a deal. This will probably take a little while. So, BIOS loaded, so it should be good to go in a Mac now, so it won't work in this PC anymore. It can be flashed back, but I'm not interested in that. So, I took one of these hard drive brackets and drilled some holes, countersunk them, and mounted 3 SSDs. So we can have... Well, I figured OS 9, OS X, and then Linux or just some extra storage. 64 GB each. So. Total of 192 GB. So I decided to place them in here where they're mostly out of the way, and I think when the power comes down here later it will be very convenient to get them here, and then draw the cables over here to the SATA card, and the IDE to SATA adapter will be installed here later for OS 9. So I hooked up the SSD to this other controller, so we're gonna try to install OS X first. I'm using external optical drive USB because the internal one doesn't read DVDs. It's a bootable device for some reason. Can read them from OS X. Because the Mac has USB 1.1 and I'm using an external optical drive, the install takes some time. So I'm gonna get it started here and then we're gonna look when it finishes. What we want to see here, if we can actually see the SSD or not. just gonna see if you can actually see the hard drive and then partitioning it. And the SSD. I have something here about 60 gigs, that should be it. Erase, I think. Might be something on it, but from what I understood from got it from, it was never used. But I haven't checked the smart data that actually occurred. Looks good. Let's continue, and we agree apparently. Yes. So can skip this already, check this before. So I will leave it here. This will take a lot longer than 13 minutes. It takes about, I think, 1 hour, 45 minutes due to the optical drive being quite slow with the USB 1.1 interface. So we'll come back to this as soon as we're done here. So our install is finished. So time to restart and hope it boots. was just the case. Some tension in something. Thank you. Yeah. About this Mac, let's check. More information. Shouldn't be any surprise, seen this before. So, let's do a reboot to see what it does. Let's shut it down. I tried to install OS 9, and the first SSD halted or froze the computer as soon as it tried to install to it. Then I tried another SSD, and that came some like 10% or something, and then it froze again. So, next option would be an IDE to compact flash adapter, and I have one of those with 8 gigs of memory, but that's way too little for any games and programs later on that I want to use, won't be enough. So I put in a hard drive again, an IDE hard drive. It's a Seagate 80 GB, 7200.7 is the model. Had another 122, but better have that in spare. These look pristine, at least. I haven't checked for sectors. Probably should, but I think they'll be fine. I usually save the good ones and mark up the bad ones, so we will try this. And I think the old one was a desk star, and the other one was a desk star too. Same models, different sizes. And they are called death stars usually, because they always break. And they were quite noisy. Seagate's drive tend to be more reliable and quieter, so at least with that way I can live with the noise if it's somewhat less. So we try again. Let's partition and get this installed. So, install is done. At least this works. And that hard drive, the Seagate hard drive, is definitely quieter than the desk star one. So let's shut this down and connect the SATA drive back again.